Nuclear potential, the boogeyman of the Cold War. Einstein knew where the world could head through using his equations, saying, "I don't know what weapons World War III will be fought with, but World War IV will be fought with sticks and stones." Thermonuclear bombs are much more destructive than the bombs created in the Cold War era, and they use both fission and fusion to do so. But it seems sort of counterintuitive. Why can fission, which breaks atoms apart, and fusion, which joins atoms, both generate energy? For the answer, special forces which reside within atoms must be taken into account. When neutrons or protons, the bits making up the core of atoms, come close together, they may exchange amounts of charges in the form of mesons. This binds the neutrons and protons together with what's called the nuclear strong force. It turns out there's a sweet spot with this binding energy. Too many or too few bits make up a core that is not very comfortable for the neutrons and protons. Because there is a shift with more stability towards the sweet spot, the energy which was maintaining the instability ends up being released. In fission, larger atoms break apart to form smaller ones, but to generate energy, the atoms which break apart must be larger than iron, the sweet spot atom size. Atoms larger than iron, like uranium, have too much repulsion from neighboring protons, which have a plus charge and repel each other, similar to the same two poles of a magnet. Fission also generates energy from the greater movement of particles, similar to the movement of heated gas particles. However, in fusion, the atoms which fuse must be smaller than iron, or bridge a gap where, even if they fuse to become larger than the iron atom, they are collectively still more stable than before. The reason for more stability with going upwards in size until the iron atom is reached has to do with less surface area per volume, which helps confine the core protons and neutrons. To visualize this, take a cube, record its surface area and volume, and then combine 7 more cubes to create a larger one. The surface area of some areas of the smaller cube now are engulfed and lost. Fusion, in fact, has great applications. It generates very little radioactive waste and can even be used to dispose of things which have been contaminated by radiation. Since it requires very high heat and pressure, magnetic confinement, which traps and heats atoms using magnets and energy, and inertial confinement, which centralizes the heat and pressure from laser beams, are currently used to produce fusion conditions. Our sun even uses fission and fusion to heat the solar system. One day, a cup of seawater will be fused to generate enough power for an entire city's daily power usage.